Welcome to The Know. I'm Brian.
And I'm Eric.
It's that time of year again. The temperature is dropping. The leaves are changing color. It's kind of chilly out. I got a fleece on. Everything has pumpkin spice in it. That can mean only one thing.
Horror movies! Yay! Yes. Horror movies. So there are so many streaming services out there, and each of them offer horror movies on there. But we figured we'd go through them. We would look and see what the best stuff is out there, because if you've ever gone through these horror sections on these streaming services, there's so much trash.
In horror movies?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. So we decided to scour Amazon, Hulu, Netflix, the big three, and we wanted to kind of point out some of the better options out there for you.
And you know a lot about this stuff, so this is good. Eric can recommend the good stuff for you. So there are a lot of obvious titles we know, like Shining, The Sixth Sense, Seven, which are all streaming on Netflix. Ghostbusters. That's not really a horror. That's kind of a comedy, but Night of the Living Dead.
It's a horror movie for like kids.
Yeah, sure. Night of the Living Dead and Carrie. Those can be found on Amazon Prime. But here are 13 quality horror movies you might have missed, forgot about, or maybe you never even heard of.
Yeah, in no particular order, let's recommend these 13 actually good scary movies to watch for your Halloween pleasure.
Awesome. All right, let's do it.
We're going to start with The Monster Squad. This is a personal favorite of mine.
Sweet.
There aren't a whole lot of family-friendly horror movies on this list. In fact, there's just this one.
Yeah, they aren't really known for being family-friendly.
Well, the good ones. The good ones. Like, but I'm the asshole that showed his little brother Exorcist when he was 4 years old.
Oh,
so,
man.
So, that, you know, his therapy bills come to me now.
Totally.
Okay, so Monster Squad is essentially The Goonies.
Okay.
If the kids teamed up to fight Dracula, Wolfman, The Mummy, and Frankenstein's monster.
Okay.
But it also has a little bit of that 80s edge as well. You know, there's cursing kids. Nice. There's, you know, kids actually in threatening situations. It's not like Goosebumps. But it does have some creepy moments, but there's always that undercurrent of fun, so it's never too intense for younger viewers. So yeah, this was one of my favorites growing up. It's still a personal favorite of mine, and if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend checking it out. It's great. On both Hulu and Amazon Prime.
All right, next up, Killer Clowns from Outer Space. I do like this one. It is a super campy, over-the-top 80s flick about an alien race of creepy clowns that come down to Earth in order to feast on its people. This is kind of like a USA Up All Night movie in the day, which I used to love, like Hell
Comes. Were you Gilbert Gottfried or Ronda Rousey?
Both, but probably Ronda for young boy reasons.
Yeah.
Of course, now these clowns, they don't just straight up eat people. They do it like alien clowns would. They wrap us up in cotton candy and suck our juices out through crazy straws. Filled with inventive gore and tongue firmly planted in cheek, this is one of the most fun horror flicks you can spend this Halloween. It is streaming right now on Hulu.
The next one up is a movie called Stir of Echoes, which I, another big favorite of mine. Kevin Bacon stars in this movie. It's kind of a classier ghost story. It's really good, but there was one little problem with the movie. It happened to come out a few weeks after The Sixth Sense.
Oh.
Now, this one's about a cynical blue-collar working man type, who played by Kevin Bacon, who was hypnotized as a joke during a party by his kind of asshole sister-in-law. And afterwards, he sees a dead girl. She wants him to do something, but what?
Oh.
That's the mystery at the heart of this really solid, very well-done, classy thriller that unfortunately got buried by another great movie. Stir of Echoes can be seen on Hulu and Amazon Prime.
Moving right along, let's do It Follows. Now, this is one of the most effective indie horror movies in recent memory. Maika Monroe plays Jay, a young woman who is being stalked by an evil, shape-shifting force after a sexual encounter. The mythology built here, it's very simple, very scary. This entity is focused on one person at a time. It absolutely will not stop until it reaches you. No matter where you are on the planet, this thing always knows where you are. It's slowly walking towards you. That is fucking terrifying. Yeah. It can look like a stranger or a friend, and if it touches you, well, that's it. Now, the movie, it loses a little bit of its momentum in the third act, but it's a great setup, and the acting is tremendous all around. Definitely seek it out. If you've missed it, you can find It Follows on Netflix.
All right, the next one up is called The Innkeepers. Amazon Prime has this one, and it's a really great haunted house tale. It's all about two desk jockeys at an old hotel that's about to close. Okay. They're determined to prove some of the hotel's haunted history before it's torn down. Sarah Paxton and Pat Healy play the two leads, and if you have a little patience with it, the movie pays off in a big, big way. Turn up the volume, turn down the lights, and I guarantee you're going to jump out of your skin at least once.
Next up, The Voices. Now, before Ryan Reynolds transitioned his career fully into Deadpool, he made this quirky, offbeat, and oddly pleasant serial killer movie called The Voices. It's about a likable young man whose cat, tells him to kill people. The film kind of plays a bit with point of view in interesting ways. Most of the movie is told from Reynolds's point of view, which is this happy 50s-ish bright sunshiny world, but he's not exactly a reliable narrator. We get some glimpses into what's actually going on in his apartment, and it's pretty brutal. Anna Kendrick co-stars. This is a very underappreciated horror comedy. It's currently on Netflix.
So the next one up is City of the Living Dead.
Okay.
This is gonna be a little bit more of a deeper cut. So hardcore horror fans have argued forever about who the best Italian horror filmmaker is. Most think it's Dario Argento, and there's a faction that prefer the guy who directed this movie, a guy named Lucio Fulci.
Okay.
Personally, there's no question that Argento is a better filmmaker. He's made masterpieces, Suspiria, Deep Red, Tenebrae. Fulci's never made movies up to that caliber, but his movies are way more fun.
Nice.
City of the Living Dead is a great example of that. Okay. It's a crazy zombie story that has wildly inventive and horribly disgusting, like, disgusting. Sweet. We're not talking about, like PG-13 disgusting
okay,
gore moments here. The story is simple. A clergyman commits suicide, and in doing so, he opens a gate to hell, and our heroes have to try to close it before hell invades our realm. The movie's silly, it's dubbed in English, but man, is it fun. It's definitely less for the casual scary movie fan and more for the gore hounds among us, but it's out there and streamable on Amazon Prime.
All right, moving right along, we've got Behind the Mask. Now, Behind the Mask, The Rise of Leslie Vernon isn't your typical masked man slasher movie like your Friday the 13th. The high concept here is that the first part plays like a documentary where film students interview a slasher in the making. Leslie Vernon is a charming guy who's in training to become the next Freddy, the next Jason. This training means a lot of cardio so he can always get in front of his target when they're not looking. So the movie mostly plays kind of like a This is Spinal Tap, but at a certain point it actually turns into a slasher movie for real. And suddenly all the stuff that was set up as jokes earlier, it becomes very real. Now we get a couple of horror legends like A Nightmare on Elm Street's Robert Englund, who classically played Freddy, and Poltergeist's Zelda Rubinstein. Great underseen film. You can stream it on Amazon Prime.
So the next one up is Blowout, and this isn't just a great kind of scary movie,
okay,
but it's just an all-around great film.
Okay.
Brian De Palma gives us the story of a sound engineer who hears something he wasn't supposed to while he was out recording wild sound for a slasher movie he's working on. The movie figured out John Lithgow was super creepy way before Dexter did,
nice.
And boy is he threatening here.
Nice.
John Travolta stars in the movie, and it's actually like legit his best performance.
It's like good John Travolta?
Good John Travolta, okay, way before Battlefield Earth.
Oh, sweet, okay.
So he's trying to solve a murder mystery using this audio thing that he picked up. And all the while he's being stalked by John Lithgow, who likes to strangle people.
Oh, fuck.
So Blowout is fantastic and is one of the best gut punch endings ever filmed. Criterion put out a great Blu-ray of this a few years back. But if you don't want to shell out the dough for one of those pricey discs, you can stream it for free on Amazon Prime.
Next up, Hush, which takes on sort of a traditional slasher home invasion template and throws a few curveballs at it. Most importantly, the lead of the film is deaf, so when she's tormented at home by a mass murderer, they find interesting, intense ways for the bad guy to use this to his advantage. Now, the movie gets fun when our heroine turns the tables and her disability becomes a strength. Hush is way smarter than it should have been. That's thanks mainly to writer-director Mike Flanagan, who most recently spearheaded Netflix's The Haunting of Hill House.
Which is really good.
Great. And a great central performance from Kate Siegel, who also co-wrote the script. This is a Netflix original.
Next one up is Frailty, starring and directed by the late, great Bill Paxton.
Oh,
he made this in 2001, and it's a film about a troubled father who believes he can see demons. So he trains his two young sons to prepare for the day when they all have to gather up as a family and kill them all.
Holy shit.
Now, cool premise. Yeah. The only problem is that these demons look like normal people to everybody else.
Oh,
so
no.
That leads you to think, is this guy crazy or is he onto something?
Right, is he about to commit mass murder?
That is the question at the center of this movie. So this is a super dark, super well shot, just well made all around movie. It has a lot of great talent on screen, like Matthew McConaughey and Powers Booth, and two top-notch kid actor performances from Matt O'Leary and Jeremy Sumpter, who later went on to play Peter Pan.
Okay.
Kind of got famous for that.
All right.
It absolutely nails the ending too. Like don't let anybody spoil this one for you if you
okay.
haven't seen it.
All right.
You can find Frailty on Amazon Prime.
All right, next up, Train to Busan. Netflix has one of my favorite zombie movies in recent memory. It's a South Korean film called Train to Busan. So yes, there are subtitles. don't let that scare you off from this movie. It's very Western in its approach to storytelling. Kind of a straightforward tale of a preoccupied businessman father. He takes his daughter to her mother in Busan when the zombie apocalypse breaks out, like it does.
As it does.
Yeah, kind of like Snowpiercer. Most of the movie is told on this train as the passengers. They're having to deal with the breakout both on board and outside. Great character work. It's got a lot of fun gore and it's fast paced. James Wan is producing an English language remake, so watch it now. And best of all, you can have bragging rights whenever the American version comes out. You can be that guy who's like, the South Korean version was much better.
Nothing better than a horror hipster.
Totally. You can hipster it out. Watch it on Netflix. Be into Train to Busan before it was popular. You're welcome.
Finally, lucky number 13 is a recent film called The Autopsy of Jane Doe. It's a stylish creep fest about a father and son coroner team. You know, the average. You know,
it's good to get into your dad's business.
Yeah, who doesn't bond with their father over, over dead bodies?
Right.
So they get a mysterious corpse in one night, and scary shit starts happening around them. Brian Cox and Emile Hirsch star in this supernatural tale as they slowly uncover just who this Jane Doe was and why her body is on their table. And also why the second she arrives, all this crazy shit starts happening.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a very smart movie. It's well shot, well acted, well scripted. It's a mostly single location horror story that escalates into some really, really dark places. This one should be more known, and thankfully Hulu has your back and can stream it.
Nice. Just in time for Halloween. Again, we sort of stuck with the big three for this list, Netflix, Amazon, and Hulu, but there are even more great horror movies to be found if you look into more focused streaming services like the All Horror Shudder or the classic movie-centric Filmstruck.
Shudder in particular has some great deeper cut horror movies available, like the absolutely batshit crazy and super fun Italian shocker Demons, Don Coscarelli's trippy 70s horror film Phantasm.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, which was served as an inspiration for Captain Phasma. Yep. That's how she got her name in the Star Wars
movies.
That's
a nice reference.
Yeah, J.J. Yeah. Abrams is a big fan of the Silver Spheres.
That's some secret knowledge for you
guys. There you go, trivia.
Yeah, exactly.
You can have that ready for your bar trivia nights.
That's right.
There's a surprisingly good and fun horror movie about killer diet food called The Stuff.
Oh.
Believe it or not, it sounds cheesy. It is cheesy. It's awesome. And it also has one of my all-time favorite 80s slasher films with one hell of a twist ending. It's called Sleepaway Camp.
All right, so hopefully this list helped you guys find some hidden gems for Halloween. And also, if you got some of your own, make sure to let us know what your favorite Halloween movies are in the comments below. And for all your entertainment, all your video game news, like this video, subscribe to The Know. Better yet, go to our website, theknow.tv. See you later.
Off of these services, that we figured it might be a good idea to see what's out there, float some recommendations. Yep. You know, if you've ever gone through any of these horror movie streaming, the horror sections of these streaming services,
you
notice that they're just way too, so much junk and trash and, oh, fuck,
in
I fucked it.
Movie? Oh, you're
I
good.
Fucked it.
Good.
I fucked it.
It's okay.
You're right.